Hello and welcome to this video for MetaWatt's new presentation regarding version 23.0.x. So, as you already know, Meta covers a wide range of categories and many disciplines are supported. Let's start with the solutions for GUI and graphics. Graphics performance is now significantly improved for specific line elements, resulting in better performance for model handling, as you can see in this diagram, and also for animation. Less RAM memory consumption is needed in comparison to competition. Moving on to the next new feature, new palette styles are now supported in the palette editor when creating custom palettes. It provides clearer results visualization, including colorblind ones. Small displacements reading option has been removed. In previous versions, having the small displacement disabled and changing the deformation scale factor to very large or small values could result in distorted graphical model representation. In version 23, this cannot happen, since small displacement is handled automatically by Meta. Also, this leads to improved responsiveness on the deformation scale factor changes when many states exist. Now let's move on to the solutions for model and results handling. Major improvement can be noticed when reading PAMGRAS ERF files as it is depicted in the diagram. It is now possible to subtract the initial results for PAMGRAS ERF files while reading states, for example, plastic strain. This can be done by enabling the minus initial checkbox that exists in the results states tab. Concerning enhancement on distances, there is up to 50 times performance improvements of part group distance calculations, and also while applying group separation, deer separation, model separation commands. Another new feature is that the session commands based on state variables, for example frequency or time, are now recorded in the session file instead of the state ID that was recorded in previous versions. This gives the advantage of better handling when running the same session for another model and facilitates adjustment of the commands since the same syntax is used in the filters. Also, new field calculation methods are now available. These calculations are the moving average, subtract divide on multiple states, and max of pairs. The 3D window title is now fully customizable. Any title combining simple text with variables about model, state, results info, or even inherent variables can be built freely. Formatting is possible for time, frequency, or any other float values. As you can see, here are some examples of customizable titles. The next new feature refers to the fringe plot. Visibility of contour plots can be adjusted with respect to the current range limits or threshold values. As you can see in this example, the contour plot below the mean limit and above the max limit is hidden. The same goes for vector results as well. For instance, vectors below a specific limit can be hidden. For isofunctions, it is now possible to create an isofunction from solid faces. Another new feature is to visually display an isofunction as a flat area. It facilitates the output of better report images and it can be useful for machine learning processes. For map results, in previous versions, it was only possible to map nodal values and not elemental centroid values. In version 23.0.x, centroid element values from a source mesh to another target mesh can be mapped. In addition to the above, it is possible to use commands which choose automatically if mapping will take place on nodal or elements and drawing values based on results nature. Moving to the solutions for results queries and reporting, the first new feature refers to the advanced filter. The title of the advanced filter now indicates from where it was called, for example from annotations tool or iFilter and so on. Until now, when the advanced filter was synchronized from more than one tools, there was no overview of the order of execution. Now there is a list in order to handle this, where the execution can be set and synchronized filters can be added or deleted. There are also some enhancements on the spreadsheet editor. Grouping of rows or columns can be done so that they can be collapsed or expanded. Also, another new feature is to freeze panes of the worksheet. Thus, the frozen part of the sheet will be kept visible while scrolling through the rest of the sheet. Let's move on to the solutions for the 2D plot. The GUI of the care functions can be totally redesigned in version 23.0. The functions are organized in better categories. Search mechanism has been added so that you can search for a certain function using the respective search field. We believe that this change will accelerate the workflow of using the tool. And last but not least, a long-awaited feature is also added, the capability to make a box selection on a curve and have the max identified there. Also, a new option has been introduced on Plots Context menu, allowing to swap the selected plot with another one of the current layout. It is possible to assign a different background color to plots of the same 2D plot window. Another new feature is to have the plot show the values of the curves only at a specific abscissa value, let's say at 260. Then these values are depicted as bar chart. It is now possible to read curve data in Meta without displaying them in a 2D window by choosing the option Data List. In this case, the data will be available under the All Windows Curve List so that you can manipulate them. For example, you can apply curve functions or use scripting functionality on them, and finally display the curves on a 2D window. This feature can be very handy in cases where several steps of calculations are required on the data. In such cases, a workflow is now possible to read just the curve data, apply the calculations, and then decide at a later step on which plots to display the curves. Moving on to the disciplines and starting with crash and safety. Suppose that the same model exists on different windows. Now the follow nodes functionality can be used only on a specific window. Like in this example, the follow node functionality has been applied only on the window 2. For the pedestrian toolbar, new functionality has been added to compare target points between different model versions. As a result, overview of heat differences is calculated. Band sensitivity analysis is now provided as a new functionality which enables the identification of points that are close to change color band. The borderline of the respective annotations are colored accordingly. Sensitivity analysis can now be performed for the projected area of EU phase regulation. It facilitates the identification of sub-areas that have the greatest sensitivity to heat changes. Lastly, new regulations are now supported. For MBDB user toolbar, compatibility assessment can now be performed according to China NCAP regulation. Additionally, it is possible to select if the evaluation area will be defined according to the selected protocol or from user-defined length and height. For the occupant injury criteria toolbar, Euro NCAP rating for heavy quadricycles now available. Also, site airbags results are now supported in this strange result. Moving on to the human body models post toolbar, Safer M50 human body bottle is now supported. Moreover, it is possible to calculate brain part contribution to total brain CSDM injury along with the individual CSDM injury of each part of the brain. Let's proceed to the NVH discipline. Calculation of elemental responses can be achieved using the FRF assembly tool. A new toolbar for flex body analysis has been introduced. The flex body motion derived from ABC results can be animated, including von Mises stress contour plot. In addition, model displacement and strain energy participations can be analyzed. The model displacement can be read instead of loads or enforced excitations. It is available for both transient and frequency response analysis. Also, acoustic responses can be calculated from the acoustic coupling matrix. For pancreas, it is possible to read damping model matrices. The results produced by model response tool are line on line with pancreas. There are new options for choosing frequency ranges. Signed von Mises stress is now available in transient response, as well as max of top and bottom for elemental results. In version 23, the user can switch between complex Hertz view and bar chart view using the frequency cross-section checkbox. Furthermore, other panels or contributors can be shown or hidden, and the NVH data are not needed. In version 22.1, the fluid structure algorithm was not homogenized. In version 23, the FC algorithm has been homogenized and is now the same in all our softwares. Pressure equilibrium coupling algorithm is now available for calculation of FC coupling matrix and it is the default one. In addition, inward and outward surge distance for FC coupling calculation can be set. Basic information regarding FCI is output as a header entry in Astron the MIG file. For model FRF bar chart toolbar, H3D files are now supported, and for TPA from forces and FRFs, the inverse FRF results from Astron punch file can now be read. It is now possible to rerun a process set in Brakes Wheel user toolbar by running the recorded session commands of the actions. Nastran results have been also supported, along with the ability to handle multiple DOEs via pages. DOEs with their experiments are assigned a unique name and they reserve a page for their post-processing plots. In addition, PIDs groups includes are now available and also the filtering by component name. For durability, new user toolbar is now available for calculating the equivalent plastic stress from a linear elastic analysis. The correction is based on the given material properties and is applied on every element using the Neuberg correction method. For CFD, new order option distribution is now available when generating flow paths from surface. User can define the number of flow paths emitting in S and T direction, similarly to flow plane option. The eye droplet option has been included on the identification methods, where the user can pick a droplet from the model. According to particle radius, meta merges particles close to each other in droplets. Then, the droplet volume, along with its ID and the number of particles from which it consists, is reported. New meta-calculated scalar results are now available. It is used to detect and visualize shock waves. It exists also as a user field function so that it is calculated using custom vector results. The next new feature refers to the solutions for the data manager. The geometry and the 3D results can now be loaded from AssamODS servers. These items appear in the M browser with relevant options in their context menu. Geometry hierarchy is both shown in the M browser tree list and as PIDs in the loaded geometry in meta. 3D results are loaded as complex deformation so that they can be directly animated. Let's move on to new features for several solvers. For Nastran, results from GPForce output requests are now supported in 3D. Support of Abacus 2022 and specific type of elements used for coupled thermal electrochemistry analysis. Also, section forces results are now supported as vector results. In PalmCras, these elements a keyword are supported, as well as 3D results from ESI Procast. For LSDyna, names of interfaces are now read when reading geometry results from interface force files. For Adios, SPH elements and the results and cluster forces and moments are supported. Support Mark HDF format and some specific formats for PERMAS, MoldX3D, MoldFlow, latest libraries for FEMZIP, and reading results from H3D is now available for PCOM properties. Two new solvers are now supported, Aceris Electromagnetic and Adventure Cluster. New features for CFD solvers, for Fluent, OpenFOAM, StarCCM, Titherm, and CFD++. Let's proceed with the solutions for automation. The utils meta command function, which is used to execute session commands through Python API, has been enhanced to return the new objects when the command reads geometry, results or curves, or creates annotations, planes, and isofunctions, or calculating curves. Otherwise, zero value is returned. Also, a new capability is given to run Visual Studio Code directly through Meta. A new menu entry is added under Tools Visual Studio Code. If Visual Studio Code isn't installed, a wizard will help the user with installation process. This allows scripts to be debugged or run in Meta directly from Visual Studio Code. Moving on to the solutions for the virtual reality, Snapshot is available from Headset's view. Also, it is possible to save images with the view of the headset or utilizing the VR menu as a live camera and adjust the field of view choosing between different aspect ratio. Thank you for watching.